Vance Schneider works away sanding some details into a styrofoam well. Just one of the many elements that will be part of the vibrant set for the Laughingstock Theatre Society's December production of Beauty and the Beast, the Panto.
Typically, we start in about late July, and we will go right into early time of November. So it's like, it's nice and warm, and then it gets really cold, and we have to paint really fast.
It's been months of work already, and there's still lots left to do.
Lathing spindles to jigsawing staircases to screwing in flats. It's just an amazing amount of work. But it's a tremendous thing when it's all put together and it winds up on stage for mere moments.
A team of dedicated volunteers is busy painting the dozens of set pieces to be ready in time for the holiday production.
I started by sanding out the flats from last year to make them smooth, ready for priming. And then I primed some of them, but then got called away to do something else.
The sets add color and they add a pleasing backdrop. We can certainly do it without, but it's much more fun with.
A set that has been in the works for months.
We agreed to have the stairs built out and the rows on top.
Set designer Jessica Scott took Vance's original sketches and drew up her own from there.
Just kind of adding life and making things look like older and lived in. Vance told me the dimensions that I needed to work with, and then from there I just kind of used graph paper and drew up, you know, the idea. I watched Beauty and the Beast twice, obsessively, and then from there I ran with like the Beast Castle and the French Village.
You wouldn't believe how good the paint's coming out though. I'm so happy right now.
A painter and tattoo artist, Jessica hopped on board with a full plate, happy to put her skills and expertise to good use.
It's good times.
I love doing like stone textures, and then anywhere I can hide trees and anywhere I can put plants or mountains. I threw mountains in there. I like teaching people, and I like just doing something so big. Like, the bigger it is, the more excited I get.
But this crew is working in a place that's perhaps not where you'd expect to see giant set pieces in progress. They're stationed out at Tronkiel Farm, tucked away in a large barn, a 4-year relationship with the farm that has only continued to blossom.
We were asked by Tim and Annette to come out and actually haunt the corn maze. We approached them with the idea of building some sets out here. And over the last 4 years, it's grown into a beautiful relationship where what we give back is everything from general cleanup of an area, that kind of thing. We do a lot of helping out as well as run the corn maze during Halloween.
A home for these passionate volunteers who spend their weekends toiling away for the sheer joy of it all. Hundreds of hours of work for what will feel like the blink of an eye on stage.
It's a lot of time, yeah. I mean, there's a whole group of us working on it, and it's only used for 1 week. So, like, everybody's just working away, and then come the end of December, we paint over it and do the whole thing all over again.
What is many artists' worst nightmare, painting over your work, is instead, for Jessica, a unique opportunity.
There's no consequences. Like, as a tattoo artist, I go to work, I do art on people, and it's intense. There's no room for mistakes. Here, it's like, oh, well, I'll just paint over that, right? It's more free and fun. It's great to be a part of the community and see your work take life. For the palace.
For a full list of showtimes and information about the production, visit www.thelaughingstock.ca. For Go Only on Shaw TV, I'm Sam Numpson.